ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ഭരണത്തിന്റെ കീഴിലേ ദൈവാരാധനയും.
At the appointed time, all such questions will be answered if you have patience.
Before you make any covenant or friendship with anyone, take Holy Spirit with you.
ജലത്താലും ആത്മാവിനാലും ജനിക്കുന്നില്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരുവനും ദൈവരാജ്യത്തിൽ പ്രവേശിക്കുക സാധ്യമല്ല.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 8, verses from 23. Jesus got into the boat followed by his disciples. Without warning, a storm broke over the lake, so violent that the waves were breaking right over the boat. But he was asleep. So they went to him and woke him, saying, "Save us, Lord, we are going down." And he said to them, "Why are you so frightened, you men of little faith?" And with that he stood up and rebuked the winds and the sea, and all was calm again. The men were astounded and said, "Whatever kind of man is this? Even the winds and the sea obey him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Kindly be seated. God is good
all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Today we meditate upon the power of God and the powerlessness of Satan. We are going to meditate about the power of God and the powerlessness of Satan. Now, how do we know that God is all powerful and almighty? We read that when Jesus was there in the boat sleeping, a heavy wind broke out. Now, when Jesus rebuked the wind stopped. Now, why the wind stopped? When I was small, I heard a poem. This poem touched my heart about this incident. A Christian poet has written a poem about Jesus calming the sea. So he explains it like this, that the waters came to know that their master, their creator, is traveling on them in a boat. So they are so excited to see the face of their creator, their master, their father. And now they gave the signal and they came up in the form of waves. And they have been risen so high to see the beautiful face of Jesus, their master, their maker, their creator. But the disciples did not know this. They got frightened and they started to shout. Then Jesus lifted his hands and greeted them, saying, "I have seen you." And they went backward, joining their hands. This is what? For the poet, calming the sea. Because this poet have just seen the power of God and this water that's just the creation. That's why at the presence of their master, the water goes calm. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, sisters and brothers, the creatures, the sea, the water, they all know their maker, their God. They know who is God. The entire nature knows who is God. They worship, they adore, they glorify their creator. It's only we humans, we are rebellious. We have a beautiful psalm. This psalm has really impressed me. This is Psalm 114. Let us look at this psalm, Psalm 114. This is a very small psalm. Let's look at this psalm, exactly what is happening when they have seen their maker. This is, when Israel, you have to imagine, you have to feel exactly what is written in this psalm. When Israel went out from Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of strange language. See the people of Israel, they are the chosen people. You and me represent this Israel. From the land of slavery and Egypt, the Lord is leading them. The Lord is leading them. Though the people cannot see God, God was in front of them. Then we read verse 2. When they have left this land of Egypt, Judah became God's sanctuary. The moment they left the land of slavery, they became God's sanctuary. Israel, his dominion. Then, verse 3, we continue. The sea looked and fled. Jordan turned back. Now see, the Lord is coming. The people of Israel is coming. And the people cannot see God in front of them. They are shouting, they are screaming, they are afraid. They can see the Egyptian armies following them. In front of them there is sea. But the waters came to know. The sea saw their master just coming in front of these Israelites. And what did they do? They fled. The sea looked and fled. Jordan turned back. And we read verse 4. The mountains skipped like rams and hills like lambs. That means now the mountain, they are the hills, they could all see God. The God is coming to visit them in front of these Israelites. Then verse 5 we read. Why is it? So now the people who are looking there, they cannot see God and they are asking a question. Oh sea, that you flee, why you are fleeing? Oh Jordan, that you turn back. Why you are going backward? Why you are giving away? Then verse 6. O mountains that you skip like rams, O hills like lambs. We are asking so many questions. Why this is happening? Why these mountains are shaking? Why they are dancing? Then verse 7. Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord. At the presence of the God of Jacob. My dear sisters and brothers, he turns rock into a pool of water and flint into a spring of water. Now see, though the human beings cannot see their maker, the entire creation they can see. Again we read, this is in Sirach chapter 16 from 18. This is book of Sirach chapter 16 from 18. You can repeat after me. Lo heaven and the highest heaven.
Lo heaven and the highest heaven.
The abyss and the earth.
The abyss and the earth.
Tremble at his visitation.
Tremble at his visitation.
Verse 19. The very mountains and the foundations of the earth.
The very mountains and the foundations of the earth.
Quiver and quake.
Quiver and quake.
When he looks upon them.
When he looks upon them.
Then 20. But no human mind can grasp this.
But no human mind can grasp this.
And who can comprehend his ways?
And who can comprehend his ways?
Like tempest that no one can see.
Like a tempest that no one can see.
So most of his works are concealed.
So most of his works are concealed.
Please believe and accept it. Like a tempest that no one can see. So most of his works are concealed. You are following us on this online live stream now. It's almost 3 months. There are so many miracles taking place. Conversion of the lives taking place. But you can't see. You are just in front of a TV. You are just joining a prayer. And you can believe that God is present there. Like tempest that no one can see. So most of his works are concealed. There are people watching from Pakistan right now, from Malaysia, from Singapore, from America, from Canada, from Kenya, from Uganda, Burundi, from Ghana, from Cameroon, from Zimbabwe, from different parts of the world. Like a tempest that no one can see. So most of his works are concealed. Our God is filled heaven and earth. We again read, this is book of Judith, chapter 16, verse 15. These are not my ideas. The Holy Scripture teaching us. This is Judith 15, 16. For the mountains shall be shaken to their foundations with the waters. Before your glance, the rocks shall melt like wax. But to those who fear you, you show mercy. Sisters and brothers, the whole earth is filled by God's power. And the creatures of this world can feel his unlimited power. Isaiah 48:13. Isaiah 48:13. My hand laid the foundation of the earth, and my right hand spread out the heavens. When I summon them, they stand at attention. When I summon them, when the Lord is there, when he just lifts the hand, the wind become calm. Believe it. Believe. All power belongs to him. Then again, chapter 48 verse 21, same Isaiah 48:21. They did not thirst when he led them through the deserts. He made water flow for them from the rock. He split open the rock and the water gushed out. As Father Joseph was mentioning at the beginning of the adoration, the same God who healed the sick is the same coming on this altar. The one who healed that woman who had bleeding. The same God who raised Lazarus to life. The same God who multiplied the bread. The same God who healed the sick. Is the same all-powerful and almighty coming on this altar. And he has unlimited power. Believe it. Repeat after me. My Lord Jesus.
My Lord Jesus,
I believe you have power.
You have all power.
All authority belongs to you.
All nations belong to you.
All governments belong to you.
Everything in this earth belongs to you.
Psalm 24:1. Let's claim Psalm 24:1. The earth is the Lord's and everything in it. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it. Believe. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it. The world and those who live in it. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Now, if all power belongs to God, why this wind came? Listen carefully. We have just read in the first letter. This is from the book of Amos. That where we read is Amos chapter 3 from 3 we read. Amos chapter 3 from 3. Do to walk together unless they have made an appointment. Then verse 4. Does a lion roar in the forest when it has no prey? Does a young lion cry out from its den if it has caught nothing? Just listen carefully. This is the first reading. And the second reading is all about calming the sea. Why did this strong wind came up there? Why? There is something behind it. We have just read the gospel. This is Gospel of St. Matthew chapter 8 from 23 to 27. Then 28 we read. Verse 28. This is Matthew chapter 8 from 28. 8 from 28. This is immediately after that Jesus came to the other side. He was on the water, then he came to the other side. Please read with me. When he came to the other side. To the country of the Gadarenes. Two demoniacs. Coming out of the tombs. Met him. They were so fierce. That no one could pass that way. Now, why the lion was roaring? Why the wind was so heavy? Why there was a lot of chaos? Because the purpose of Jesus was to cast out the demons. So who came in the form of the wind? Satan. That is why we just read, this is Matthew chapter 8. Let us read how did he calm the sea? 8:26. Matthew 8:26. And he said to them, why are you afraid, you of little faith? Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a dead calm. What did Jesus do? He rebuked the winds. Repeat. What did Jesus do?
He rebuked the winds.
Repeat, what did Jesus do?
He rebuked the winds.
What did Jesus do?
He rebuked the winds.
What did Jesus do?
He rebuked the winds.
Now, you don't want to rebuke a wind because it has no life. You don't want to rebuke some natural things because it is not going to do anything. Whom he has to rebuke, that means there is Satan behind it. Let's read. Now, where do Jesus rebuke? This is Luke chapter 4 from 40. That means Luke 4 from 40. Luke chapter 4 verses from 40. I will read it from my Bible, where there was an incident that has happened. This is Luke chapter 4 from 40. They brought to Jesus, as the sun was setting, all those who had any who were sick with various kinds of diseases, brought them to him. And he laid his hands on each of them and cured them. Demons also came out of many, shouting, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked him. Who rebuked him? Jesus. Whom he rebuked? Jesus. The demons. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, the moment we started to talk against demons, our word of God is not working. That means it has real power. He is so upset. That is the way we come to know that the tricks of the evil one. He will do everything to stop talking against him about his deceptions. He is a deceiver. Sisters and brothers, he can only do all these things, but he has no power. Jesus rebuked the evil one. He rebuked. So whom to rebuke? The devil. Again, this is Gospel of John chapter 10 verse 10. What are the tricks of the devil? Now we read. See, now it is come. So his tricks are defeated. So now things are come out. So now we read. The thief comes only to steal. Who is the thief? The devil. Thief is the name of devil because he is a liar, he is a deceiver, he is an accuser, he is a blamer. He is the one who destroys everything. So the devil comes only to steal, kill and destroy. Listen carefully. A human being cannot steal things of others. A human being cannot kill another human being. A human being cannot destroy another human being because human beings are created in the image and the likeness of the Lord. So if anybody does stealing, killing, destroying, is the work of the devil, the deceiver. Sisters and brothers, look. You can only see, you and me can only see a wind. But Jesus, the master, his eyes can see the demon behind it. That's why he rebuked it. I was in Kenya for many years. And I can see I also got malaria. There's a beautiful sickness called malaria. And this sickness has a speciality. Once you are affected by malaria, you can be misguided. It's like coronavirus. What is the speciality of malaria? And I know malaria and corona may be members in the same family. They are cousins. Now, what is the speciality of malaria? It's also it's caused by mosquitoes. Now, if you have malaria, sometimes it can come out in the form of headache, sometimes in the form of stomach pain, sometimes in the form of fever, sometimes in the form of loose motion. But our fathers call loose motion as slow motion so that people don't say something. So they ask, have you started to have slow motion? Then they understand this is malaria. Now, if you don't know, when you get just fever and you go and swallow some kind of paracetamol, what will happen? You cannot detect malaria. When you go and check, your fever will not get out, malaria will not go away. Because malaria is like a devil. It always misguides. It's always in disguise. It will not express its special nature. When I got this malaria, I had a flu and a cold and a cough. And I thought of just taking some kind of this coldarin, you know, this kind of medicine, like Avil is a medicine for cold. But my priest friend told me, no, Father, you have to go and check malaria. When I checked, I got positive. Then my priest smiled, he laughed, he was became very happy, and he told me, now you are baptized as an African. Because if you don't get malaria, you have not yet baptized as an African missionary. After all, for him, he can laugh. But for me, but anyway, I accepted, because at least I could see my brother priest laughing, because he is so happy, because he is not the only one. I also have this. Now, after all, when you see a wind, unfortunately, you only see some wind. But when are you going to get this gift to know there is something behind? When you have a coronavirus, when you have sickness. See, devil can cause sickness. Let no one deceive you, sisters and brothers. Devil can cause allergies. Devil can cause sicknesses. Devil can block marriage. Why Sarah's marriage was blocked? Demon. And even his name is also written in the Bible, in the book of Tobit. There are people who refuse the existence of devil. That is the greatest deception of the devil. If there is no devil, why did and whom did Jesus cast out? It's a very big joke, and devil will laugh at and smile loud to those people who say, oh, no, there is no devil. It's just an absence. It's an absence of good. There are people who say devil is an absence of good. Let no one misguide you. If there is no devil, whom did Jesus cast out? He's there. He is there, and he can cause sickness. He can block marriages. He can cause childlessness. He can cause allergies. He can cause different type of sicknesses. Even when we were praying, even let us read. These are not my fantasies. This is Gospel of Matthew, where Jesus is casting out this sickness from. Let us read. This is Mark. Chapter 4 from 35. Mark from 45. Mark 4:35. Sorry. Mark 4:35. Mark 4:35. On that day, when evening had come, he said to them, let us go across the other side. You know. Then again, what happened? Leaving the crowd behind, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. The other boats were with him. It means that same incident. And now, how did, when these waves came up, how did Jesus calm it? By rebuking it. And again, when this is Matthew, now it is, let us read chapter 8, verse 16. 8:16. That evening they brought to him many who were possessed with demons. He cured them, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and cured all those who were sick. See, people brought to Jesus many people who were sick. And what did Jesus do? Cast out the spirits with a word. That means why they were sick? Demon caused them to be sick. So he cast them with a word and cured all who were sick. So that means, when we are attending this prayer service, when you are participating in this, even when the mother-in-law was sick, this is, again, let us read, this is Luke chapter 4, verse 39. Luke 4:39. You can all read together with me. Then he stood over her. And rebuked the fever.
See,
is fever a person to rebuke? Is caused by demon. Is caused by demon. And it left her. So, even this coronavirus, today as we were praying for this, the Lord was asking me that, why can't you let people pray a deliverance prayer? A prayer for deliverance. That is important. Let us not just reserve it for priests or bishops, and now we know that nobody is there to pray, nobody is praying, and we just take things for granted. If there is an anger that you cannot control and you cannot overcome it, you have to cast out and rebuke the demon of anger. If you are obsessed with games, remember Satan is holding on to it. You are to rebuke the spirit of certain games which is full of violence, sex and immorality. There are many games. Children cannot get out of it. I did not know about it because I don't have these games with me. Jeremiah, one of our wonderful choir members, he told me about the dangers of this social media. He told me. So he also gave a session to the youth when we had a retreat in St. Mary's Church in Dubai. I was so shocked and surprised that even the names of these games are so many different games, and children are being captured by it. They cannot escape. And I had a vision that when that we had a session for these children, we could see out of these instruments like the cell phone, small demons are coming and choking the neck of these children. They cannot escape because it's an evil attack. They cannot stop it. That means we need to rebuke the evil of games, even gambling, even certain sexual sins. If you cannot stop it, you need to rebuke and cast out. Are you ready to do that, or are you afraid of that? Don't be afraid, because we read in CCC 395, Satan is just a creation. That means they are the fallen angels. They are not the creator. They have no power. We read in Romans chapter 16 verse 20. Romans 16 20. They have no power. All their power is being removed. They have nothing. All authority. The God of peace. Let us repeat this word of God together. Raise your left hands and repeat. Sorry, left hands is in the left side. Don't worry. Nobody has seen. Okay. Repeat. The God of peace will shortly crush Satan.
The God of peace will shortly crush Satan.
Under your feet.
Under your feet.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
The God of peace will shortly crush Satan under your feet.
The God of peace will shortly crush Satan.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
The God of peace will shortly crush Satan under your feet.
The God of peace will shortly crush Satan under your feet.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
Again, 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 verse 3. 2 Thessalonians 3:3. 2 Thessalonians 3:3. Let us claim it together. But the Lord is faithful.
But the Lord is faithful.
He will strengthen you.
He will strengthen
and guard you from the evil one.
And guard you from the evil one.
Believe it. The Lord is faithful, and He will strengthen you, and He will guard you from the evil one. Again, 1 John 3:8. 1 John 3:8. 1 John 3:8. The last word, the last part we'll read together. Together, raise your hands and repeat after me. The Son of God was revealed for this purpose.
The Son of God was revealed for this purpose.
To destroy the works of the devil.
To destroy the works of the devil.
The Son of God was revealed for this purpose.
The Son of God was revealed
to destroy the works of the devil.
To destroy the works of the devil.
The Son of God was revealed for this purpose.
The Son of God was revealed
to destroy the works of the devil.
To destroy the works of the devil.
Now look into my eyes. Do you believe that the Son of God was revealed? Yes or no? Yes. Did He defeat the works of the devil? Why do you have doubt? This is the trick of the devil. He will always create doubt. He is defeated. He has no power. The Son of God was revealed for this purpose, to destroy the works of the devil. So what you have to do? Use this authority and rebuke him. If the scripture says, this is Matthew 28:18. All authority is in heaven and on earth is with me. Together we claim it. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Given to whom? Given to whom?
To me.
Given to Jesus. All authority in heaven and on earth is given to Jesus. And this same authority He has given you and me. So those who said me, that's also right. He has given that authority to us. All authority. Let me ask you, Did Jesus give some small authority to Satan? No. All authority means everything there. Let's again read Ephesians 1:22. Ephesians 1:22. Where the Father has put, believe it, He has put all things under His feet. Under whose feet? Under the feet of Jesus. So where is Satan now? Where is Satan now?
Under the feet of Jesus.
But then why did people are afraid of Satan? Why did people are afraid of Satan? Because Satan can also perform certain kinds of tricks. 2 Thessalonians 2 from 8. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 from 8. 2 Thessalonians 2 from 8. Why do people are afraid? And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord Jesus will destroy with the breath of His mouth, annihilating him by the manifestation of His coming. Now, when Satan is coming, what do Jesus do? Just take a breath. Have you heard that noise? He is annihilated. There is no power for Satan. Believe it, sisters and brothers. Just taking, he's finished. This is the scripture. Believe it and declare. Repeat after me. Then the lawless one will be revealed.
And the lawless one will be revealed.
Whom the Lord Jesus will destroy.
Whom the Lord Jesus will destroy.
With the breath of His mouth.
With the breath of His mouth.
Annihilating him.
Annihilating him.
By the manifestation of His coming.
By the manifestation of His coming.
Let's also read verse 9. The coming of the lawless one is apparent in the working of Satan, who uses all power, signs, lying wonders. Remember, Satan can use powers, power, signs, and lying wonders. That means he can manifest himself like a lion. This is what we read in 1 Peter chapter 5 from 8. He comes in the form of a lion. Form of a lion. Is he a lion? No. Then who is the lion? See, discipline yourselves, keep alert like a roaring lion. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around, roaring like a lion. Is he a lion? I can bark like a dog, bow, bow. But I'm not a dog. I can make you afraid. I can hide. I used to make my little sister be afraid by barking. I am not a mimicry artist, but one of my priest friend had this gift. He used to bark like a dog, exactly like a dog. And our superior got frightened. He used to do that. Satan can do this. He is roaring like a lion, but he is not the lion. Then who is the lion? That you should know. Who is the original? Revelation 5:5. Revelation 5:5. Jesus Christ. The one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. See the lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David." Who is the lion of Judah? Jesus Christ. J-E-S-U-S. Don't forget that. He is the lion of Judah. And he has all power. He has annihilated the satanic power. Now, while I was in a retreat, a person came and told me, "Father, but I can see real miracles in a satanic church." Then now, sisters and brothers, we read, we have already seen Satan can also perform lying wonders. They are not real wonders. We read the same incident in the book of Exodus chapter 7 from 8. This is Exodus chapter 7 from 8. What is happening? Moses was being sent to the palace of Pharaoh, and then Pharaoh is asking, "Who are you?" Then we read verse 9. The Lord said to Moses, "Then Pharaoh says to you, 'Perform a wonder.' Then you shall say to Aaron, 'Take your staff and throw it down before Pharaoh, and it will become a snake.'" Now, there are so many magicians, which doctors are in the palace of Pharaoh. Moses and Aaron is going and telling them, "Release our people of Israelites." Then the Pharaoh is asking, "Who are you to say this?" Then they said, Moses said, "God sent us." So Aaron put his staff down and it became a snake. Then we read verse 10. What happened? Verse 10. So Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh and did as the Lord had commanded. Aaron threw down his staff before Pharaoh and his officials, and it became a snake. A staff became a snake. Then we read verse 11. Then Pharaoh said, it's not a miracle. He summoned the wise men and the sorcerers, and they also, the magicians of Egypt, did the same by their secret arts. They also had staff, stick, they put it through it, they all became snake. Look into my eyes. Now how many snakes are there? So many snakes. One snake made by Aaron, and the other snakes made by the magicians who were in the palace of Pharaoh. There are so many snakes. Then what happened? Verse 12. This is the most important scripture. Most important scripture. Each one threw down his staff and they became snakes. But Aaron's staff swallowed up theirs. Aaron's staff swallowed up theirs. Now how many snakes are there? 10? 15? 1. The snake that became from the staff of Aaron. Sisters and brothers, there is only one Savior. There's only one who will remain. This is Jesus, and Jesus, and Jesus alone. All power belongs to him. That the death is been swallowed by him. Sickness is been swallowed by him. Disaster is been swallowed by him. And he remains victorious. Now believe it. Now don't be surprised. Don't run away. Now just because people have seen so many snakes, they will run away until they see the end game where Aaron's snake swallows up everything else. Believe it. Power belongs to Jesus. Powerlessness belongs to Satan. He has no power. He has no power. Believe it. All authority, all power. Colossians 1 from 16 we read. Everything belongs to Jesus. Everything, all power belongs to him. For in him all things in heaven, all things on earth were created. Things visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions. Praise the Lord. Kindly stand. We are going to make a powerful prayer that you are joining with me in this Eucharist, and we are going to claim it wherever you are in any part of the country. At least once in our lifetime, we are to make this powerful prayer of deliverance. By the power of this Eucharist, we are going to command every kind of wicked spirits to get out of us. You have to join with me in this prayer. This prayer you will be able to see. This must be prayed with the bishop. We have a bishop called Bishop Joseph Srambikel, and in communion with the bishop or in communion with the priest. That's why even if it is not there, sometimes it's important you pray it. I know certain people who pray it privately and personally, and they have experienced the power. There are certain secret sicknesses. Doctors cannot heal us. We don't know the secret. We only see the wind, but we don't see the spirit behind it. When the lion is roaring, it has seen something. There is something behind. When this coronavirus is there, maybe there is something. It's an evil attack, and we need to rebuke. If Jesus rebuked the fever in the life of the mother-in-law of Peter, we also have, God is giving us that same authority to rebuke the evil one. You can repeat after me this prayer. You will pray, and it is here on the screen. So you have to repeat, pray after me together with me. You can together, we pray together because I am praying with you. You can look onto the screen. Pray together with me. Most glorious Prince of the heavenly armies, Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in our battle against principalities and powers, against the rulers of this world of darkness, against the spirits of wickedness in the high places. Come to the assistance of men whom God has created to his likeness, and whom he has redeemed at a great price from the tyranny of the devil. Holy Church venerates thee as her guardian and protector. To thee the Lord has entrusted the souls of the redeemed to be led into heaven. Pray therefore the God of peace to crush Satan beneath our feet, that he may no longer retain men captive and do injury to the church. Offer our prayers to the Most High, that without delay they may draw his mercy down upon us.
take hold of the dragon, the old serpent, which is the devil and Satan. Bind him and cast him into the bottomless pit, so that he may no longer seduce the nations. In the name of Jesus Christ, our God and Lord, strengthened by the intercession of the Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of Blessed Michael the Archangel, of the Blessed Apostles Peter and Paul, and all the saints, and powerful in the holy authority of our ministry, we confidently undertake to repulse the attacks and deceits of the devil. God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven. As wax melts before the fire, so the wicked perish at the presence of God. Behold the cross of the Lord, flee bands of enemies. He has conquered, the lion of the tribe of Judah, the offspring of David. May thy mercy, Lord, descend upon us, as great as our hope in thee. We drive you from us, whoever you may be, unclean spirits, all satanic powers, all infernal invaders, all wicked legions, assemblies and sects, in the name and by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, may you be snatched away and driven from the church of God, and from the source made to the image and likeness of God, and redeemed by the precious blood of the divine Lamb. Most cunning serpent, you shall no more dare to deceive the human race, persecute the church, torment God's elect, and sift them as wheat. The Most High God commands you, he with whom in your great insolence you still claim to be equal, he who wants all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. God the Father commands you, God the Son commands you, God the Holy Ghost commands you, Christ, God's Word made flesh, commands you. He who to save our race, outdone through your envy, humbled by himself, becoming obedient even unto death. He who has built his church on the firm rock and declared that the gates of the hell shall not prevail against her, because he will dwell with her all the days, even to the end of the world. The sacred sign of the cross commands you, as does also the power of the mysteries of the Christian faith. The glorious Mother of God, the Virgin Mary, commands you, she who by her humility and from the first moment of her Immaculate Conception crushed your proud head, the faith of the holy apostles Peter and Paul and of the other apostles commands you, the blood of the martyrs and the pious intercession of all the saints command you. Thus, cursed dragon, and you diabolical legions, we adjure you by the living God, by the true God, and by the holy God, by the God who so loved the world that he gave up his only Son, that every soul believing in him might not perish but have life everlasting. Stop deceiving human creatures and pouring out to them the poison of eternal damnation. Stop harming the church and hindering her liberty. Be gone, Satan, inventor and master of all deceit, enemy of man's salvation. Give place to Christ, in whom you have found none of your works. Give place to the one holy, Catholic and apostolic church acquired by Christ at the price of his blood. Stoop beneath the all-powerful hand of God. tremble and flee when we invoke the holy and terrible name of Jesus. This name which causes hell to tremble, this name to which the virtues, powers and dominions of heaven are humbly submissive, this name which the cherubim and seraphim praise unceasingly, repeating, holy, holy, holy is the Lord, the God of armies. O Lord, hear my prayer,
and let my cry come unto thee.
May the Lord be with thee,
and with thy spirit.
Let us pray together. God of heaven, God of earth, God of angels, God of archangels, God of patriarchs, God of prophets, God of apostles, God of martyrs, God of confessors, God of virgins, God who has power to give life after death and rest after work, because there is no other God than thee, and there can be no other, for thou art the creator of all things, visible and invisible, of whose reign there shall be no end. We humbly prostrate ourselves before thy glorious majesty, and we beseech thee to deliver us by thy power from all the tyranny of the infernal spirits, from their snares, their lies, and their furious wickedness. Deign, O Lord, to grant us thy powerful protection, and to keep us safe and sound. We beseech thee through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
From the snares of the devil, deliver us, O Lord, that thy church may serve thee in peace and liberty. We beseech thee to hear us, that thou may crush down all enemies of thy church. We beseech thee to hear us. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world, for the ruin of souls. Amen.
Praise and worship the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, I claim power, I claim protection, I claim security. Let all your people who are watching this program, attending this, let them be protected. No evil touch them, no harm come to them. We command archangels and angels, all angels, choirs and seraphim, cherubim, thrones, powers, dominions, virtues, principalities, archangels and angels, cover your people, give them protection and security. Let sicknesses be healed, bad habits be removed, satanic afflictions be removed, every kind of afflictions be removed, wrong relations be broken, satanic possessions be delivered, people be set free. Let the blood of Jesus set them. Shandabada mandira bahara bariya, sagarara bala mandira bahara bariya, shandira bahara bariya, sagarara bala mandira bahara bariya, shandira bahara bariya, shandira bahara bariya, mandira bahara bariya. Sharma, deliver your people, set them free, wash them, cleanse them. Jesus, let your power be manifested. Jesus, let your glory be manifested. Give them security, give them protection. In your name we pray. Deliver your people, deliver your children, deliver your people. Let marriage take place, let childless couples be blessed, let financial bondages be broken, allergies be broken, coronavirus be healed. We rebuke the sickness of corona in Jesus' name. Let there be deliverance. Many sick be healed, many who are possessed to be delivered, many who are afflicted be set free. Those who are not able to get married, let their marriages take place. Those those are childless, let them receive children. Those are financial bondages, let them receive a financial breakthrough. Those who are sick, let them be delivered. Those who are in bondages, let them be set free. Jesus, let your power be manifested. Those who are unable to study, let them study. Those who are unable to concentrate, let them concentrate. Those addicted to social media, movies, pornography, filthy things and bad habits, let them be set free. Jesus, in your name we pray. We claim your power. We claim your power, your presence. Let there be mighty deliverance. Mighty outpouring of the power of the Lord. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, every bondage, every sickness, every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. Our offertory hymn is, there is power in the name of Jesus. We claim it, we sing it together. As I am going to lift to the potter and the chalice, as I am going to lift to the bread and wine, we are going to lift your life with every bondage. Don't be afraid. We belong to Jesus. Power belongs to Him. Power belongs to Jesus. Devil is a deceiver. He is defeated. He is crushed under the feet of Jesus. We claim it. If Satan is afflicting anyone, we rebuke it in His name. And we declare, there is power in the name of Jesus.